from Hollywood, Guns and Roses.
Thank you. know now that I got to see a little bit of what I want to hear until the day I got more and more. Just get coming again, a little better than, a little better than before. Do a little bit of what I want to do until the day I got more and more. I just kept trying to get a little better than, a little better than before. Give me a little Paul McCartney and Wings, does he? When you were young and your heart was an open book, did you just say, live and let live? Living out of pride.
This is a new little ditty featuring Mr. Izzy Stradlin. Titled Dust and Bone.
Yeah.
That was worth fucking interrupting me for, I guess. No, it wasn't, dude. Tell you a little bit about this show. There might be a delay between different songs because we just have this big fucking list and we pick which song we're gonna play next as we go to see how it feels best with you. That way we don't get bored and you don't go and I saw that show in Toledo. Fuck that shit. Also, we'll be playing a lot of new stuff, seeing as how you people have waited a really long time for the album to come out. And it'd be kind of a really pussy-ish thing to do to just come up here and play Appetite for Destruction. It's kind of like jerking on. But we got a new video out. That people like you have seemed to put on number one on request on MTV and the radio stations across the country, which we're real surprised at. We never thought it would happen with that song. It's just something we recorded that song. We actually wrote it before we recorded the first album. That's why it says Bitch Slap Rap and Cocaine Tongue on Appetite. But we just kind of threw it out there so that the rockers would have something to listen to while we were working on our ballad shit. But you guys have kind of stuck a firecracker up its ass and it just took off. So without further ado, we'll be right back. Fuck yes. Give me a little Rod Stewart.
Take it slow.
You meet a lot of people, and you meet a lot of Guns N' Roses fans and shit, and you go, like, how can you talk to me and ask me these questions when you're a Guns N' Roses fan and you've listened to our albums, you've listened to us talk, and I know there'll be things in the press that someone else wrote and it'll be twisted and upside down, but I'm just trying to figure out. What is it? I must have some huge reputation for lying my ass off all the time. I guess that's just it. It's like, basically, if you're talking to Axl, argue with him and don't believe him because he just is known for lying in his music and in his personal life. He just lies all the time, I guess. Is that what he does? I just think it's kind of amazing, you know, that like, you talk to people and you go, you mean, you could actually say that to me and you actually listen to a song like Rocket Queen. I guess, you know, maybe Sebastian's right, you know, when it's like, and maybe I'm like one of the Nelsons and I just make shit up. Maybe I just make shit up all the time. Maybe I'm so full of shit that I am nothing but a motherfucking double talking jive motherfucker.
Yeah.
some light. This is something new and different. Hey, bitchin', someone broke the piano. That's cute. It better not fall. This is something that a lot of you may already fucking own, since it sold about 3 to 5 million bootlegs. Impatient motherfuckers.
I can see a long restraint.
While Slash is finding his shoes, what happened to his shoes anyway? I'm sorry, am I ignoring you? I like these guys' company. Yep, up on a soapbox. How are those shoes coming, Slash? I didn't come out here to do stand-up comedy. St. Louis. I'll tell you a little something about the city.
Put some shoes on, dude.
I was 17 and I left Indiana because I had a disagreement with one of the juvenile detectives. And he was determined to put my ass in jail, and I was determined to get the fuck out of Dodge. As he was driving to my house, I was getting my clothes out of the dryer and getting the fuck out of Dodge. And I had about $35, and I took a bus to St. Louis. Yeah, that was cool, you know. And I had about a half a joint, and I went down by the arch, and I smoked half a joint. And then I went out by whatever freeway I was closest to, and I hitched a ride with some air conditioning repairman in a van. It all seemed pleasant and safe enough, and nothing really much happened, and I was like exhausted, beat, never been out of my fucking town on my own in my life. And we went to some fucking hotel and I crashed out, you know, and this guy crashed out. And I woke up and this guy was trying to fuck me. I don't care, you can be male, female, you can be a fucking dog. I don't care what you are, man, that shit ain't right. No, but I guess I'm just homophobic, you know, that's my problem. Anyway, it took everything I had inside of me. I pinned this guy against the wall between the door of the hotel with my straight razor because I thought I was bad to shave with a straight razor. And it took everything I had not to fucking slice his jugular vein. And you know that movie, Escape from New York? I guess they filmed a lot of it here or something. So that was kind of my first experiences of knowing where I was. Do you know where you are? Do you know where you are? All I know is when I was here and I was 17, I was in the middle of the fucking jungle, baby! I was about to die!
You can hear the red light, you won't be there with me.
change my fucking clothes. Because the pants I was wearing fucking broke and my balls were hanging out. I'm not pulling an Angus Young here, okay?
Yeah.
Something new. I hear what you're playing, but this is featuring you. This is something new called, is it, wait, 14, queer 14, 14 years, that's funny. 14 beer.
I try and feel the sunshine. You try and hold me down. With the rain, you try and always complain. You want to fear up to my neck in sorrow. You just make me. You just don't step inside for 14 years.
star, Mr. Izzy fucking Stratlin. There's a man who leads a life of danger. On the bass guitar, the king of beers, Mr. Duff Rose, my fucking king in. On the Budweiser can and the piano, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Dizzy Reed. And on the drums, this guy. Our USS GNR battleship, our destroyer, our tank, our gunrunner, our mercenary from hell, our concrete fucking underpant fucking wearing drummer, to show you why he is in this fucking band.
Thank you.
Well, thanks to the lame ass security, I'm going home.
Thank you. piece of a fucking piece of seat torn off without the bowls.
We want to get as many faces as we can destroying.
Thank you.
equipment.
I need a fucking raise.
Billion.
Left of all those shit.
Please get off the stage fast. Hooter, don't get on there. We don't know what's live up there.
Power to the stage, everything's out locked.
Yeah.
I want to make sure it's not live. I don't know.
They told me they cut the power.
Yeah, I don't know. Like,
guys,
hey,
everybody up there, please. Please. We know everything's live up there. Everybody yeah. Just be out there and get it sorted out. All right, Blairs.
You're all right, bud.
Just don't worry about it running anything, you know.
How many blowjobs did you get tonight?
One.
Looks like you'll last for a while, huh?
Yeah.
My girlfriend blew it.
Yeah. Robert, just get the sod in the lights. Thanks, sir.
Hey, Phil?
Hey,
Phil, what do you think about the lights?
Oh, yeah. The head might be good, I don't know.
Tennis, anyone?
Stop, or I'll say stop again.
Hold that up!
The quietest in the
in the country.
We'll be back after these words from our sponsor.